Hi everyone, welcome back to Healing Souls. So today we are going to do a reading for career and finances. So in this reading we are going to see your predictions for the career or finances, what changes are coming for you, what the guidance universe wants to give to you. So it could be relating to you, or it could be relating to anyone on your mind, any dear one who is a source of finances for you. So it can relate to your parents, it can relate to your children, it can relate to your siblings or to you, so that you will be intuitively guided to whom it is related to. So here we have four options in front of you. This is option one, this is option two, this is option three, and this is option four. You can select the options based on the crystal stones also. Whichever crystal stone is calling on you, or whichever pile or whichever color calls you more, you can select that pile. Just relax, breathe in. Pile 1, pile 2, pile 3, pile 4. So I hope by now you must have made your selections. So I'm going to keep pile number 2 aside. Pile number 3 also, I'm going to keep it aside. And pile number 4 also, I will keep it aside. So we are going to begin with pile number 1. This is pile number 1, and everybody who chose pile number 1, we are going to read for your career and finances. This is a jade stone for root chakra. Root chakra healing, a stone of abundance, a stone that brings abundance into your life. Wow. So here we see your first card as the Wheel of Fortune. Wow, amazing. So destiny taking a shift on you. Wow, Nine of Pentacles. Great. Cards are looking very positive. Ace of Wands or Ace of Rods. Queen of Wands. Queen of Wands or Queen of Rods. Rider. Rider. Wow. We have another card which says Dog of Far away, a distant friend is thinking of you. So it is possible in this, with the Rider card and a distant friend, travel can be involved. One important month when your career is going to start, this Wheel of Fortune is going to turn in your favor, is January 2021. For some people, it is possible that you already started in 2020 January, and so in the coming 9 months you will see progress in this. Club, there's a card which says someone will try to make you do something against your will. Okay, so you have to avoid this person. We'll see who this person is. Joy, there's a card of joy. This is yellow colored card. Your solar plexus chakra is absolutely healed. This is wonderful. Energy work. Yeah, so with the Queen of Wands, I was already sensing that, you know, many of you are energy workers, healers here. We are going to see this card. There's another card which says Seven of Earth. Seeds well planned, a temporary pause in the action, unnecessary worry. Okay, so this is where you're coming from. communicate clearly. So in order to manifest this abundance into your life, you've got to work on your throat chakra. Communicate clearly is the message. Okay. Again here, fifth chakra, Archangel Gabriel. This again, fifth chakra talks to me about your throat chakra. You've got to work on your throat chakra. Animals, your life purpose is connected with animals, something to do with animals. Release jealousy. So this jealousy is stuck in your heart chakra. You've got to work in your heart chakra as well, because miracles cannot manifest with a negative emotion of jealousy. So this is what you need to work on. Do energy working. Positive recognition awaits you, dear friends. This is beautiful. In the near future, positive recognition awaits you. And the ninth house is evident. The activities of your ninth house, that is broadening your horizons, either spiritually, academically, or a long journey. Yes, travel is involved here. There is spiritual career that is, you know, coming up for some, and there is studies, academic. Some people are traveling for studies, which is going to be beneficial for them. This is beautiful. So dear friends, to begin with your reading, Seven of Earth, this card tells me that at present you are waiting for some kind of changes. You've put your hard work, seeds well planted, you've put your hard work, and there is a temporary pause. In 2020, I feel there has been a pause. There has been a situation that you've been waiting with patience, and the angels say that the worry is unnecessary here, because what is predicted for you is karmic rewards with the wheel of fortune, destiny taking an upswing on you, and you are going to absolutely, your financial status is going to be very comfortable. Very comfortable. The card of Nine of Pentacles, dear friends, talks of abundance, luxury, self-love. There's a woman in this card who is absolutely enjoying in her independent business, work, profession. Or even if she works in a company, she is independent in the accounts that she's handling. And this woman, not just, you know, she's not a woman who is just putting her hard work. She's a woman who is enjoying luxurious life now, because of all the hard work that she's put in. She has come to a status now where she has this beautiful garden. She's got birds, she's got animals, pet animals around her, and she enjoys luxury. This is your future, dear friends. Ace of Rod tells me that a new opportunity of your passion, if you're in your own profession, your own business, you are going to begin something that you're very passionate about. A new opportunity is approaching. You are beginning something. If this is a business, you are going to invest in a new idea. If this is for service people, I see that you are going to leave your job now. The time has come. Wheel of Fortune indicates a big shift. So you are going to leave your job, which was, you know, giving you lack, and you are going to absolutely take another job. Queen of Wands tells me that there is a middle person involved here. This middle person can be an agent, a person with the fire sign Leo, Sagittarius, or Aries person, can be your friend, family member, somebody around you who can maybe, you know, initials of their name can begin with M, A. There can be a Virgo sign person also around with P. This can be a help, a healer, this person who can help you manifest this job opportunity, this business, this profession for you. You can be a spiritual healer yourself, dear friends. A very strong intuition for healers, middle persons is here. People who are doing energy work. Okay, so you can be an energy worker yourself. The card says life can be electrifying because its very essence is energy. Your body is a remarkable energy field that will positively respond to loving treatments. Your hands and heart are activated to give healing energy to your loved ones and clients. Okay, so many of you can be Reiki healer, pranic healer, yoga teachers. Or there is some kind of a healing that you are giving with your hands. You can be doctors, you can be nurses. It is also possible that there is a healer around you who is giving you healing sessions, because of which you are going to have this destiny shift in your career. Okay, so energy work is connecting very well with you, which is going to bring this manifestation. And even if you are a person who is not doing any kind of work, like a job, a service, then also you can be a woman who is having this benefit of this luck of money coming towards her through her husband, or through the, you know, whatever her husband is doing, a business, or through her father, or somebody is having a success which is leading to a lot of abundance to a partner's life. Okay, and so the Rider card over here tells me that there is a victory waiting for you. There is going to be public recognition and victory as well. This card, you know, because we see a horse, a person riding a horse, so I do see this card as travel being involved. So it is possible that this big destiny shift takes you to another state or another country. Okay, and there is a far off friend, a distant friend who is thinking of you. So this person, who is a Leo, Aries, Sagittarius or Virgo sign person, can be one of your friends who helps you in manifestation of this new career opportunity for you. Okay, then we have another card which says positive recognition. This is what is heading for you in future, dear friends. Congratulations, they say. Your plans have worked out perfectly and now it's time to shine. Brilliant new ideas will present themselves to you and success is all but assured. Express yourself openly and honestly, knowing that those surrounding you are trustworthy. Be open to unexpected opportunities. This is very beautiful, dear friends. So here you are being guided to be open to unexpected opportunities because they are going to bring you name, fame, recognition. Be open to your friends, colleagues, middle persons who are giving you these opportunities or these offers. Okay, and here there is a card which says someone will try to make you do something against your will. Okay, so there can be a person who is, it is possible that in your past you are in a work scenario, in a business, in a job or something, where a person is being very nasty on you, dominating on you, who is making you do something against your will. So you are being guided to leave this particular scenario and move from this job, as leave this job, as you know, better is waiting for you. There is another job which is waiting for you. Okay, your destiny is shifting. Definitely by January you will get this job, and within within the 9 months of getting this job, you are going to be abundant. You are going to be living a life of comfort. This is very beautiful. So release jealousy. It is possible that people around you are very jealous, and so you don't have a conducive environment in your work area. So, or it is possible that you yourself have this negative emotion of jealousy, that whenever there are other people joining your office or your partnerships or your businesses, you become jealous. So this is jealousy is a negative emotion that we need to release from our heart chakra, dear friends. So you need to work on your heart chakra, do your inner child healing. The card says jealousy is an affirmation that you don't have something, and the universe manifests exactly as you affirm. Let other people's successes inspire rather than frustrate you. If they can have it, so can you. Okay, so this is very beautifully explained here, dear friends, which tells us that, you know, when you see other people progressing in life, do not feel jealous of them. Appreciate them, because you know universe is abundant. There is no dearth of things in universe. It is not that only 1, 2, or 10 people can have. Universe has so much abundance for everybody. So you know, if they can have, you can also have. You've got to work on your heart chakra, on your emotions of jealousy. This is very important, and it is also possible that you are communicating with harshly with a few people around you who could be of help to you. So it is possible that a friend, far off friend, who's trying to be a help of you, you are just very jealous and you are not communicating well with them. Okay, so release jealous emotions and you will succeed in life. So animals is a part of your life purpose. Either you can work with animals as in your profession or career. This can really bring you growth. Here also we see a dog. Okay, so animals can be a part of your, you know, life purpose, or else it is possible that abundance can come into your life if you take care of animals, as in feeding dogs, feeding crows, cows, or any animals around you, birds. You are going to manifest abundance in your life. It is also possible that these animals are your spirit guides. So you know, you will be guided. Now you will be seeing more animals around you, and you will understand that, you know, they have a connection. There are certain messages that they are giving you. It is also possible that, you know, animals are very healing for your heart chakra when you keep a pet with you, and this pet helps you release these feelings of jealousy and help you heal your heart chakra, because only after the healing of your heart chakra, your inner child, you will be able to manifest these miracles in your life. So get some energy work done on you. The card here says you understand animals and communicate with them intuitively. Trust your inner guidance, as the animals are part of your life's work. So yeah, for some people, this is assured that if you are looking for a guidance on your life purpose, working with animals is a part of your life purpose. Okay, and you communicate very well with animals. Here we see a card which says communicate clearly. You are communicating better with animal kingdom than with humans. So you've got to work on your throat chakra. I think you're not being able to express your heart and mind through your throat. So it's very important, whatever you want, if you want this to manifest for you, this abundance, you've got to communicate with the middle persons, the agents. Fifth chakra here also, Archangel Gabriel. Fifth chakra talks about the throat chakra here again, dear friends. Throat chakra healing is very important for you, because it is possible that you know, this connection can be with far off countries, and language is important. So you need to work on your throat chakra, dear friends, so that what you're trying to communicate in your interviews, what you're trying to communicate for your businesses, your professions, is understood well by all of the persons whom you're trying to communicate it to. Because ninth house energy is an expansion energy to another country, to the people of other cultures. Dear friends, ninth house energy is very the house which is very evident at this time for the progress of your financial growth, your career, is the ninth house, which tells me that people from foreign land, people from another culture, can be important for you. Okay, and ninth house also talks about higher knowledge, wisdom. You can also take courses, you can join courses in another countries which can help you manifest this abundance for yourself, broadening your horizons. Okay, you can do some online courses, or maybe you can travel and join a course in another country. And spiritually also, ninth house is also talking of your spiritual awakening. For the healers, it is very good period. You can start your business, you can also expand your online business, you can start your YouTube channel, your pages on Facebook, on Instagrams, and you can give your healings to more people. Academically also, this is a very good period for students or on a long journey. So ninth house talks about journey. So journey, I feel, you know, travel can be involved for some of the people here. So this is very beautiful, dear friends. If you've been waiting for changes, January is not far. Start looking for, come out of this negative situation where someone is trying to make you do something against your will. This can be a toxic person who is using you. It can be somebody in your work area who is taking favors from you. Leave this work area. Okay, dear friends, I see the destiny shifting, lot of abundance and comfort coming for you. Month of January is important. I sense that your root chakra is getting healed. If you're taking energy healing sessions, your root chakra is getting healed, and by January you will be in a state of attracting abundance to yourself. This is good, dear friends. So pile number one, I wish you all the best. This reading looks very positive for you. You need to communicate well, work on your heart chakra to release jealousy, and work on your throat chakra. Your solar plexus chakra, sun is absolutely shining on you, is very well healed now, and your root chakra also, I feel, is healed, is getting healed. You are getting more grounded and practical now. All you've got to work is on your throat and heart. Okay, so now we are going to move on pile number two. Thank you very much, dear friends. So this is pile number two, and everyone who chose pile number two, we are going to see your career and finances messages and predictions from the guides for your future. Okay, the stone that you've selected is for the solar plexus chakra. This is the amber stone. This attracts a lot of joy. Sun shining on your solar plexus chakra. Good. This is a stone for confidence also. Let us see your cards, dear friends. Month of August is important for you. Either it can be something that started in August 2020. Some email, some information came to you which can manifest now, or it will be the month of August 2021 that will be important. We'll see it. Okay, let's see your tarot cards first. Okay, you have the Queen of Rods here. Queen of Rods. You have the Six of Rods, the Victory and Success card, dear friends. Name, fame, recognition is heading towards you. You have the Temperance card, the card of balance and divine timing. Wow. Queen of Pentacles, dear friends. Queen of Pentacles. We have a Scythe card. King of Pentacles, along with the Queen of Pentacles, dear friends, the King of Pentacles. Wow, this is a this is a power couple together. Are you planning to do a business with your husband? This is a power couple. How do I keep this? Wow. But this Queen of Pentacles is looking towards here, and the King is giving money also. So you've started your own business, And your husband is also doing well. Wow, amazing. You are getting money from your father or your husband also, and you are doing your own business also. Wonderful. Wow. This one is a strong financial growth. Gong, an exciting event. Wow. There's an exciting event that is going to take place. These can be your mother, father announcing some kind of a heredity money for you guys. Moon changes in your life. Okay. So you are going through moon cycles. A big change is about to occur, but you are stuck on this cycle. Somehow I feel that, you know, this moon cycle is here. You've got to, you know, make this moon cycle move with your rod. Impartiality. God and divine is saying that we are connecting to you through your crown chakra. The Temperance card also tells me here that you have a divine connection. Oh my God, another moon card. You are psychic people. You have intuitions, great intuitive ideas. There is something secret in your spread that has not been revealed till now to you. Important psychic insights, events behind the scenes, release fears that hold you back. Yes. In order to move from these cycles of moon, you need to release fears, dear friends. Yes, anxiety. Oh my God. Anxiety. So people who are affected by moon energy are mostly water signs. Cancer, Pisces, Scorpios are affected a lot. Sensitive people are affected a lot. Intuitive people are affected a lot. And they go through a lot of anxiety during these cycles, and you are stuck on these moon cycles. There have been cycles in your life, a same pattern that is going on repeating year after year in your life, and you want to break this pattern now. Okay, so you've got to come out of this negative thinking pattern. For this pile, I would suggest that, you know, you've got to take your third eye healing. You've got to take the healing sessions. Clear your third eye chakra. You will get intuitive messages. You are getting your crown chakra is very well connected to divine. Your solar plexus is healed. Yes. Name, fame, recognition is coming into your life. Guardian of thought. Wow, you may be called upon to be a speaksperson for a cause close to your heart. Your angels give you the perfect words and you'll do brilliantly. Wow. You may be asked to be a mentor or find one yourself. So this Queen of Rods can either you become a mentor, a spiritual healer, a teacher, a middle person, a lawyer, somebody who is an agent, or you are called, or you will connect with a mentor, a healer, a teacher. Okay, the situation involves someone who is professional with a positive attitude and fresh ideas. Okay, so you know, there can be a person who heads into your life who has positive ideas and who brings manifestations to your career, profession, your business. This person, who could be you, it can be you also, may be emotionally unavailable. Yes. Okay. Yeah. Over here we see this emotional instability is here. So, you know, you've got to take healings for your moon, your third eye, to clear the, you know, clear your brain of the fog that is all around there. Okay. Positivity, faith and optimism. Yes, this anxiety, this negative thinking pattern which is there has to be worked on. Positivity, faith and optimism. You open the doorway to positive experiences and opportunities with your positive expectations and energy. Yeah, you've got to work on this negative thinking pattern. Take the magic wand in your hand and start to move the direction of your energy from negative to positivity. Open the doors to positive experiences and opportunities with your positive expectations and energy. Do not allow negative energy or temporary setbacks to interfere with the path that you are on. Keep the faith and keep going. Yes. Yes, dear friends. A lot of abundance is awaiting you. Stability is awaiting you. Your root chakra healing is going to bring you, ground you to a lot of stable energy. I feel many of you can be healers by nature, you know. And what is happening, you need to balance your chakras. What is happening that in the process of your healing, you are attracting a lot of negative energy for some of the healers. Oh my God, we got the healer card here. Yes. So this is my pile of healers. This is a pile of healers. So healers over here, I talk of doctors, nurses, even people who are working in orphanages are also healers who are taking care of sick people, of children who are not having their parents. These are this is a category of my spiritual healers, pranic healers, the healers like Reiki healers, Sekum healers, then yoga teachers are also healers. Teachers are healers. Spiritual speakers are healers. So this is a category of people who are sensitive emotional. Even if you are not in a profession, you can be a woman who is giving healing services, or a man. And you know what you're doing in the process of healing others, you are absorbing their negative energy. You've got to cleanse yourself of this negative energy, and then victory, success is waiting for you. You've got to cut your cords with after your healing sessions. You've got to cut your cord with your clients. Get your cord cutting done by the healers, and then you will see how you become stable in your energy. You have the spiritual gift of healing and a desire to share it with others. Yes, you have a spiritual gift of healing within you. So if you would, if you are a person who has come to this reading to know what is your life purpose, you are a healer by nature. You can be a psychiatrist also. Any kind of healing is your life purpose. Okay, so have confidence. Another card which says have confidence. Okay, because of this, whatever negativity you are attracting and you are at times thinking of giving up on your profession, no. Have confidence. You will build in your strength. Moving forward does not necessarily require you to have confidence in yourself. Confidence in God is enough. Along with knowing that God works through you and with you in all ways, lean upon us if your confidence wavers, and we will buoy your courage and faith. Okay. So again here with impartiality card and the temperance card, I see that God is their divine angels, high spiritual beings are working with you when you're giving your healings, your services to people. So for you people, you should have confidence on the other spiritual beings that are working with you to give healing to your clients. You are going to come out of these stressful situations, these stressful moon cycles. And also, you know, if you are going to do meditations on full moon and new moon days, you are going to really benefit in your third eye chakra, your intuitions, if you're tarot card readers, you are really going to benefit from these manifestations. On the full moon, if you're healers, you are going to get energy from the moon. Just work on your subconscious mind, come out of your subconscious thought pattern that nothing is going to ever manifest for you. As they say, big happy changes await you. Big happy changes for finances, stability in your body, in your career awaits you, dear friends. Seventh house. Yes, dear friends, definitely this is my category of people who are healers by nature, because they are seventh house deals with relationship with people, relationships in your families, with your clients, with your partners in your businesses. So seventh house energy is evident for this pile. They say this area of your life is about long-term significant partners, romantic, business or family. So dear friends, at this time you are making partners for your expansion in your career and in your finances. It is possible for some of you a romantic partner is coming towards you, who is going to bring abundance into your life. With the Queen of Pentacles and the King of Pentacles, it is possible that a marriage, a settlement is going to bring abundance. For others, it can be a partnership, a financial benefit from the parents that is coming. For some, it is a business partnership between two persons, which is going to bring financial abundance and success in the career. For some people, it is spiritual partnership with your clients or some other spiritual beings who are joining you, giving you healings as well, upgrading you. Okay, so this area of your life is about long-term significant partners, romantic, business or family. So some kind of a business in the family can also bring you success. This is what is heading towards you, dear friends. An exciting event is heading towards you. So with the Queen of Rods and the Six of Rods, I can say that the time ahead is very fast moving. If there was slow energy around you, there was stuck energy around you, movement is going to happen now. Victory, success, public recognition is awaiting you. You have to take the magic wand in your own hand and make this move. Come out of this negative mindset and make this move for you. You are being called to stand for a cause. That is something that is close to your heart. You've been called to speak for that cause, and you have confidence in that, as whole of the angelic realm, the divine ascendants, your ancestors, your deceased ones in the heaven, all are standing by your side. In divine timing, dear friends, you are going to manifest abundance, stability, property, a good house with garden, with a lot of money, you know, abundance, comfort for you. Look at this man, how much money he's having in his safe here, and a coin in his hand. You're going to become like this person, stable in divine timing. This is what is heading towards you, dear friends. It is possible that, you know, something you start now, which is going to show its manifestation by August 2021. It is also possible that you've got to cut your cords with the negative people, and also you have to make a move, because with the Scythe card, I see that you've got to cut, I feel that there is kind of, you know, there is a home. Maybe you have to move from this home to another place. A movement can be involved. There is some negativity that is attached with this place. You have to cut your cords with low vibrational places, persons, and become more optimistic, dear friends. And follow impartiality. If you've been partial towards Some people you follow impartiality between poor and riches. Don't, you know, pay more attention to rich people only. You be impartial. An exciting event is about to happen in your life, and this can be a new job coming to you, a business partnership coming to you, your marriage, a new exciting offer of a job, or a hereditary money also which can come to you. You are going to, if you are a healer, you are going to become stable in your energy. Big happy changes await you, dear friends. Your main focus is around relationships, so this spread, how financial abundance is going to come to you, is going to come through relationships. Work on your anxiety. Take our healing sessions. This will really help you, and work on your negative thinking patterns. Okay, dear friends, so I wish you all the best. Pile number 2. Victory, success awaits you in divine timing. Lot of stability, money, big happy changes, you becoming a healer, positivity, faith, optimism, good relationships, confidence, you being called to be a spokesperson. Work on your anxieties. Work with the energy of moon to heal you. August 2021 is going to be a very, very important month for you, dear friends. So moving on to pile number 3. This is pile number 3, and everyone who chose pile number 3, we are going to see what are the predictions for your career and finances in the coming months. Pile number 3, you've chosen carnelian. This is a stone for sacral chakra, for your passions, for your relationships. Relationships with your partner, with your parents, your siblings, your work area partnerships. This is your creativity stone also. This is a stone of passion. So you are going to be creative and passionate and beautiful and doing some self-love. Great. Let's see your cards. Wow. Creativity and abundance. Wow. So much resonated. So picking up an oracle card only. Creativity and abundance, dear friends. So you are going to do something very creative which is going to bring abundance into your life. It can be for some of the ladies who were house ladies. They are going to begin their work from home, and this is going to be some creative work which is going to bring them abundance. Okay, so I am seeing a lot of children. If you see this card, dear friends, you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 children around her. So there is, it is possible that you open a crèche, a place where kids come for playing, and they also learn some, they study also something, or something creative you are doing with kids. Maybe you will start your online teaching for these children. It says, dear one, you are being called to action. You are ready to accomplish great things and truly come into the fullness of who you are. Wow. It's a time for great creativity, giving birth to beloved projects, or becoming a parent. Follow your passion so that abundance and prosperity manifest for you. Beautiful. It is also possible, dear friends, for somebody who has picked this pile, becoming a mother or a parent is going to bring a lot of prosperity to them. The child who is coming into their family is going to bring prosperity. Wow. Oh my God, I'm getting goosebumps. So your energy vibration card is the Emperor. The Emperor is the accumulator of finances. The Emperor is the card of highest financial comfort. So wow, finances look really good for you. Beautiful. Page of Pentacles, dear angels, I also read this card again. I read this card as a childbirth also. So it is possible that there is a birth of a female child in the family, or can be a male also, but I'm sensing a female child in the family who is very lucky, bringing a lot of abundance to you. Maybe you start your own business with this, or there is some kind of a financial growth that is coming to you. With the Page of Pentacles also, dear friends, I sense that, you know, there is a kind of new opportunity which is heading towards you. This can be an opportunity to learn something new. It is possible in your same work area this opportunity comes for you, or it is possible that a new job offer, altogether new, comes to you. This is a new seed. This is like, you know, something very stable that is coming. If you're in business also, this is some kind of a stable business idea that is coming to you, which is going to lead you to become an emperor. This can be an education opportunity for you, for learning something that will lead you to this post of an emperor. Yes. Ace of Swords, yes. This card talks about a divine gift, an idea that is coming to you. Yes, so there is an idea that is coming to you, a divine gift, which is going to bring a lot of stability to you. It is also possible that a father, a brother, a husband, an elderly person in the family is, distributing their heredity money to their children, because there are children around here in the spread. This one also looks like a child, so it is possible that your father is blessing you with some heredity money that is bringing abundance towards you. Yes, okay, yeah, of course. This is Six of Pentacles. If you see this card, dear friends, you will realize that there is a man in this card who is distributing, who is doing charity to the beggars, or some, you know, we should not call them beggars. We should just say that this person is doing charity for needy people. So this, with this Six of Pentacles card, I can say that there is a person around you who is a fire sign person, who is a Leo, Aries or Sagittarius person, who is going to distribute his or her wealth to you. And this is how your financial status is going to rise. In near future, I see that, you know, this financial abundance is going to come to you through this person. Can be your husband, your father, your brother, your boss also. Can be your boss also. Somebody is doing charity. You are also being advised, dear friends, if you are in the position of this emperor, having a lot of abundance in your bank, you are being advised to do charity for people who are who are less fortunate than you. You can be writing a book, you can be publishing something. There is a divine idea, an aha moment happening for you, which is absolutely opening your abundance. There's a card of heart, soulmates here. This is so beautiful, dear friends. For some people, I feel this is a marriage proposal. There is a marriage which is going to bring stability. Yes, because anchor, the card of anchor to me means stability. So for some people, there is going to be a stability coming in their marriage. Because of their marriage, they getting married to a wealthy partner, financial growth is coming towards them. Or for some people, because they are doing something that is their soul desire, or they are doing something with their soulmate, with their husband or wife or their soulmate, which is bringing stability and financial growth in their life. There is a card, dear friends, Ram, which says a stubborn, aggressive person. So, you know, Ram is also symbolic of an Aries person. So, there can be a stubborn, stubborn, aggressive person around you who is now distributing. I feel that there is an Aries person around you who is distributing their finances. This stubborn, aggressive person is getting healed, I guess. And this person is, you know, now distributing the finances. Or if you are a stubborn, aggressive person, you need to release this energy to bring abundance into your life, and you do some charity. Marriage. Wow. There is a card of marriage, dear friends, over here. And for a lot of you, I feel that, you know, this abundance is coming to you through your marriage. For some, it is, you know, a new marriage with a soulmate or a partner who is bringing this abundance into your life. And for others, it is your hard work that you kept putting in your marriage, and now you are going to be rewarded by a senior person, maybe your father-in-law or your father or somebody, or your husband, somebody who is gifting you some heredity money. And you know, so there is stability coming in your life. This is how your financial growth is going to happen, you know. For a child, there is a lot of financial heredity money that is going to come to his father through their grandfathers. Something like that is going to happen for a child. Elephant always talks of expansion, dear friends. This is a very, very blessed pile, I must say. You are very much blessed. Your root chakra, your sacral chakra is very well healed. You are in good relationship status right now with your family members, with your bosses, or you know, anybody around you, and you are being blessed. So this card of elephant says a long journey, either physical or mental, will leave you wiser at the end. Okay, so it is possible that you went through a long journey in your marriage with your in-laws, with your parents. There was a long time where you went through ups and downs in your family, when you suffered also financially, but now you are in a position that is going to bring this long journey is going to bring you has made you wiser, and now this is going to bring abundance into your life. For some people, there is a journey, literally there is a journey, maybe because of their marriage. They getting married to a person who is from another state or a country. This abundance is coming to you. There is a physical movement for some people. For others, there is maturity. Even this man can be it is possible that you are an aging person in 60s, 70s, and you know, money is coming to you now. Money and stability is coming to you in your life through retirement. You are being able to enjoy this abundance, and you are being able to share this abundance with your children also, and you feel absolutely blissful in your married life with your kids. This can resonate with somebody who is, you know, aging and feeling abundant. Instinct. There is a card of instinct. This card tells me that you're very well divinely guided. There are animals around you, elephant, ram, dogs, foxes. There are animals around you who are your spirit guides, your loved ones communicating through spirit animals and blessing you. Feeding animals can really help you increase your abundance, dear friends. Savor vows of poverty. My God, this is one of the luckiest piles, I can say. Dear friends, you are moving into an ultimate life of abundance, and forever and ever. If you've ever been in this scarcity, if you've ever suffered scarcity in your life of anything, just know it right away. Whenever you see this reading, this is a timeless reading. Whenever you see this reading, from that time onwards, you are out of the poverty, out of the scarcity in your life, you are now going to earn karmic rewards, dear friends. So the card is very beautiful, dear friends. They say, dear ones, there's no need to suffer or sacrifice. I feel, you know, I'm getting goosebumps. This is my pile who has really done a lot of hard work. You've gone through a lot in your life. You've grown from bits and pieces with a lot of hard work. And so I have with all my heart and soul, I have tears in my eyes when I read this card for you. I'm feeling very grateful to divine, to God, for blessing this category, third category of people. My pile number 3, I literally have tears in my eyes. I'm so happy for your manifestations. And the card says, dear ones, there's no need to suffer or sacrifice. Hold the intention of undoing any vows of poverty or self-denial that you may have made consciously or unconsciously if in any lifetime. Okay, so there is even a karmic healing that has happened for you. There were debts from past life, dear friends, that you had to pay, and now whatever age you are, these debts have been paid for you now, dear friends, and you are moving absolutely into the cycle of abundance now, and there is going to be no scarcity, no poverty for you. You are going to be so abundant now that you will be able to do charity. I think this is my category of people who always wanted to do charity. This is my category of people who always wished good for others, but they prayed to God and said that if I ever had enough, I would give to others. So dear friends, a lot of abundance is heading in your life. I'm so happy for you people. So please, now is not the time to sacrifice. Now is the time to receive from the universe, okay? As you do so, all effects of these vows will be undone for everyone involved in all directions of time. So this is a very powerful card, dear friends. It talks a lot to me. It tells me that not just you, all of your extended family, your community was, you know, under the vows of poverty, and with your good karma, with your hard work, with your whatever you have been doing, good services, business, giving to people, you have even cured their karma. You have pulled them all also out of poverty, and now there is going to be no scarcity in your generations ahead. You are going to be very prosperous. You are going to be very powerful. You are going to be very abundant, dear friends. I'm very happy for you, dear friends. Lot of prosperity, abundance, stability awaits you, dear friends. Just most probably, you have been so hardworking, you have been so much sacrificing that, you know, in the process you became stubborn and aggressive as a person. Now, you know, open your heart, dear friends, because trust in the universe that, you know, there is going to be no poverty ever after for you. I'm speaking so much for this pile. I'm getting so emotional with this pile, dear friends. And the card of the Wheel of Fortune, dear friends. What more could we have asked for? The card of the Wheel of Fortune. Destiny taking a shift. Yes, dear friends. Savor vows of poverty now. Abundance is ahead of you. A time of prosperity. Positive change, a situation suddenly moves forward. Fortune is on your side. This is so beautiful, dear friends. I can't tell you how beautiful, how happy I feel for my pile number 3 people. Elephant talks of prosperity, wisdom. Six of Pentacles talks of divine gifts. Emperor talks of abundance and stability. Page of Pentacles is a seed of stability. Ace of Swords is the card of divine blessings. An idea of opportunity is coming to you. Marriage is an expansion, union of two true souls. Anchor is a card of stability. Wheel of fortune is destiny. Uplift. This is not my pile who are going to play lottery and win through Wheel of Fortune. This is my pile of hard work, dear friends. You've won it. You've come to the level of an emperor's stability. Very beautiful, dear friends. Lot of luck is coming for you. I'm very happy for you. Wheel of Fortune, destiny is changing for you, dear friends. We have another card of a spiritual teacher here. Your life purpose, dear friends, involves being a spiritual teacher. It is possible that you are an aged person now and you are even retired, but you know, your life purpose always centered around being a spiritual teacher. You are a spiritual person by nature. You heal with your classes, sessions, and seminars. It is also possible that either you will take some healing sessions or seminars, or there is a healer, there is a spiritual healer around you who is making this destiny shift happen for you. Or it is possible that you yourself are a spiritual healer, a spiritual teacher, dear friends. Oh my God, this is so beautiful. Even if you are a spiritual teacher, a healer, lot of success, abundance comes ahead for you. Whatever your profession is, dear friends, what awaits you is a lot of spiritual knowledge. Wow. Joy and abundance awaits you, dear friends. Open your heart chakra. A stubborn, aggressive person, you have to come out of the energy of a stubborn, aggressive person and open your heart chakra. Now, the time ahead for you is for joy and happiness, dear friends. Joy is the highest energy of all. It's the magical sense that everything is possible. Wow. Joy springs from appreciating the gifts within each moment. Joy allows you to attract and create your present and future moments at their highest possible level. Yes, dear friends, it is time for opening your heart chakra and experiencing the joy. You can take our inner child healing sessions, dear friends, and open your heart chakra and manifest this abundance and come out of this scarcity mindset, dear friends, forever and ever for your generations ahead. What is coming for you is abundance. Savor vows of prosperity. Poverty, dear friends, and prosperity is coming ahead. There are helpful people around you, dear friends. In order to manifest this abundance in your life, if it is for a job, business, or a profession, you can check with the helpful people, agents around you. You don't have to do everything on your own. There are people who are going to help you. Yes, manifest these opportunities. Oh my God, Goddess of the Moon, dear friends, if you will do meditations with the moon energy during the full moon nights, during the new moon nights, you're going to manifest a lot of abundance for yourself, dear friends. Goddess of the Moon also tells me that you are a very intuitive person, or there is a woman who is very intuitive around you. She is a goddess of moon, dear friends. She is in your life. This person can be your married partner, or this person can be a partner of your child, or this could be you. There is an intuitive person around you who is like a goddess in your family, and this person is a lucky charm in your family who is manifesting a lot of abundance. This person can be like your child. This person is manifesting abundance in your family. Wow. Last but not the least, we have the Jupiter, the planet of luck, dear friends, the Wheel of Fortune. This is the second time Wheel of Fortune. Jupiter is the associated with the card of Wheel of Fortune. Jupiter is the sign of Sagittarius sign people. Have confidence, courage, self-belief and luck. Wow, dear friends, what is heading for you is great luck. Look at this boy flying. Oh my God. Dear friends, time ahead is beautiful for you. Lot of prosperity. This is a card of luck. Finances coming to you, abundance coming to you, lucky opportunities coming to you through helpful people. This pile number 3, you are very lucky, very, very double luck with the Wheel of Fortune and the Jupiter card. What is coming ahead of you is only and only abundance and prosperity. If you've ever felt scarcity in your life, say bye-bye to scarcity, dear friends. Never ever feel scarce. Distribute with two of your hands. Do charity, dear friends, as much as you will do. Do charity to kids, to charitable institutions. Do charity, dear friends. In marriages, give abundantly to the couples who are getting married. You are blessed, dear friends. Pile number 3, I wish you all the best. This was such a beautiful emotional reading for me. So now I move on to pile number 4. Everyone who selected pile number 4, this is a reading for you regarding your career and finances. The stone that you've chose is jade. This is for your heart chakra, your inner child healing, your forgiveness. With this stone, I feel that, you know, miracles can manifest in your life now, because I feel that you have healed your heart. Green is the color for you now, dear friends. Prosperity ahead. Wow. Let's see your cards. Wow. Ring. Wow. Ring. Somebody is going to get a diamond ring. Prosperity, money in the form of material gifts. Wow. Somebody is going to get married. Somebody is going to get a business commitment. Somebody is going to get a gift. Wow. Amazing, yeah. Good cards for you. Let's see. Okay, I begin with your tarot cards. Oh my god, which one should I begin with? The Fool, dear friends. The Fool is the card of the new beginnings in your life. Take that leap, dear friends. Wheel of Fortune, destiny. Wow, great destiny. Nine of Cups, your wish is being granted, dear friends. If you ever wish for anything that would bring material benefit into your life, if you thought that a birth of child would bring material benefit in your life, that will happen. If you thought travel, change of job and travel would bring material benefit, that will happen for you. If you thought that marriage and commitment in business will bring, that will happen for you. Dear friends, pile number 4, your wish is granted. Whatever you had on your mind is going to manifest for you. Take that leap of faith. You've healed your heart chakra. You are now like a small child who is willing to take that leap of faith into unknown. With this pile, I sense travel can be involved, because the Fool is traveling all over the world. There can be opportunities through work, through business, through professions which take you to places. You are going to be very, very satisfied, dear friends. If it is financial growth which is going to come to you through your marriage, it is going to be very successful marriage also. A lot of satisfaction and abundance is going to, your destiny is absolutely going to change with this new beginning that is about to happen in your life. Here we have a card of the Queen of Swords. So there can be an air sign person who is involved in the manifestation of this whole opportunity of financial growth for you. This person can be a Libra, Aquarius, or a Gemini person, and this person can also be the person who will take interview for you, who is seeking somebody. If you see this woman, this person is seeking somebody from far off land, is looking for someone. So there is a possibility that there is an opportunity that awaits you in another state or another country, and there is an interview that is heading for you for this opportunity for a business. This can be a business partner, this can be a professional person joining hand with you, or this can be somebody in work area for your job who is seeking a person from another country or state. Yes, or this can be somebody, a woman who was looking for a partner for marriage and stability. So an air sign person is evident here. With the balance card here, dear friends, again, this is a card of Libra, balance. I see that you people have gained a lot of balance in your chakras now. Your third eye chakra is absolutely clear. Your mind is very sharp. You know clearly what you want now. Your heart is healed. Your mind is sharp. This pile is very beautiful. This pile is ready for new beginnings. This pile, I think, has been taking healings through our channel, and they have healed a lot. Wow. Ear card, there is a good news that is coming for you. Wow, amazing, yeah. Fan, there can be fan followings also for you. So they say romance, celebration, and party heading for you. Romance, celebration, and party. Wow, dear friends, abundance is coming to you through your romantic partner also. Celebrations, parties, commitment, I feel. That I just felt something in my throat, some hormones. Somebody over here is feeling that, you know, this cannot happen for me. Why I got all the hormones in my throat. Somebody is feeling very anxious. This will happen for you. Don't, you know, clear what is happening in your, why are you, you know, your thyroid gland is having some kind of problem. No, I just got so many hormones stuck in my throat, as if, you know, somebody who is listening to this, maybe somebody is a cross listener who is listening to this for someone else, feeling very jealous. Not good. Wind chimes, peace and harmony. Wow, peace and harmony is ahead. This is very beautiful. Oh my God, dear friends. Besides, you know, financial abundance, I also see soulful joy coming for you. Wow, dear friends, a lot of abundance and peace and harmony and soulful joy is coming to you through this commitment of business, profession, or marriage, which is heading towards you, or a contract from another country or state. Wow, this is absolutely very beautiful. Oh my God, they've given a time span also. So much of clarity is coming within the next few weeks, dear friends. So if you're waiting for this opportunity, dear friends, it will happen in this month, November or December, or whenever you happen to see this reading. This is timeless reading, but I will definitely say not more than four weeks, dear friends. Within a few weeks only, this will manifest for you. This new opportunity is manifesting for you within a few weeks. This is very beautiful, dear friends. You're going to hear a good news coming to you. Wow, we have a card of wedding already. So for a lot of you, dear friends, your manifestation of financial abundance is going to happen through a wedding. You're going to get married to a person who is financially stable. So the wedding card says, marriage is the union of two souls joined in love, mutual respect, and commitment. It signifies a desire to deepen love over time. Your wedding day is a testament to your well-founded faith in love's power. Yes, you've healed your heart chakra. Continually breathe life into the faith, into that faith and love, dearest one. Wow, this is so much more than just your career and finances, dear friends. Here, you know, in this one, I feel that for somebody, financial abundance is coming through their wedding. So it is possible that somebody who is listening to this spread is not working, is a woman, is a girl who wished that, you know, she would ever get married to a prince charming who would have a lot of money also. You're getting married to a person who has a stable business or a stable job, who is very loving, caring also. This person can be a Piscean, Cancer, Scorpion person also. Wow, another card of abundance, dear friends, Empress. Empress talks about a very abundant lady who enjoys all the luxuries of life. And Empress talks about a woman who is giving birth to a child also. So it is possible that for somebody, birth of a child is bringing abundance and financial growth in their life. For a mother, it is possible that your child is going to, your son or your daughter is going to do something, is going to have a movement also, they said, of a wheel of fortune, a great luck, a traveling opportunity through which this child, this of yours, becomes very abundant in their life. They manifest a lot of money. Lavish abundance. Oh my God. Give birth to your dreams. Nurture yourself and others. So, okay. So, whatever this new opportunity this is coming towards you, in which you have to just take a leap of faith. This is something new. Might be that you have not done this thing before and you have to take this leap of faith in this opportunity. It is going to bring you a lot of abundance, dear friends. A lot of abundance. It can be like, you know, totally that, you know, if you were say having a salary of 30 lakhs per annum, you are going to have a salary of 1 crore or plus per annum. This is like, you know, absolutely a leap of faith. 3 or 4 times your money is going to raise. This is something, you know, amazingly beautiful that is manifesting for you within a few weeks. Yeah, yes, again, a card of the world, dear friends, here. A card of the world which tells me that, you know, this is an expansion to your career, to your business, to your profession, and you are connecting to the people worldwide over. With the world card, it is also possible that you are expanding your online business. You're doing something online and connecting to a lot of people worldwide, or it is possible for some people, as I said, there is an opportunity of manifestation of work in another country with a lot of raise in your finances. It is possible that through wedding, there is a person who moves to another country and their financial condition improves, you know, multifolds. There is another card which says, take a divinely guided chance. Yes, take a leap of faith. With the Fool card and this card, I say that, you know, there is a big destiny. There is a big opportunity which is coming to you in, you know, flicks of seconds. And you have to grab this opportunity, dear friends. You've been waiting for this opportunity. You were seeing options around you. You were seeking. You were on LinkedIn. You were on various sites. You were connecting to people with very many countries, and now this opportunity will come to you in flick of moments. And the angel says, a positive change and successful venture involves a degree of risk. Yes, with the Fool card, this is a degree of risk. Definitely you have to either leave the place that you are living in, or you have to leave the job, you have to leave the profile of work that you are doing, you have to start a new business, you have to start a new profession altogether. This is a There is a risk involved in this opportunity, definitely. But dear angels, your universe is telling me 100% that with this leap of faith, you are going to be satisfied. All positive change and successful ventures involve a degree of risk, and you are ready to follow your divine guidance to new territories. Oh my God, dear friends, yes, new territories. This is definitely the pile which is moving to new state or a new country for setting up their businesses out there, to start their career, their job, their professions out there, to even set up a new home out there. This is definitely a pile which is making a move. As you leave behind that which is comfortable and familiar but no longer appropriate for you, you make room for new and more meaningful opportunities. Oh my God, dear friends, I'm getting goosebumps. Definitely, this is a pile of my friends who are already living a comfortable life here. Yes, I don't say that wherever you are living, you are not living a comfortable life. You are living a comfortable life. But dear friends, there is a big risk involved in this change, and the universe is telling you to take this leap of faith and jump to this new opportunity which is coming to you in another country, most probably. And you know, just believe the universe. This is, once you step out of your comfort zone, you are going to manifest abundance, like multifold of abundance for you, dear friends. This is heading for you. Wow, this is beautiful. You're on the right path, dear friends. For all of my friends who are in two minds whether this opportunity has come to them, or they are seeking these opportunities in another countries, another states, or these risk involving a lot of finances, move or something, you know. Dear friends, the angels confirm to you that you're on the right path. Keep doing what you're doing because it's working for you. Beautiful, dear friends. Keep doing whatever you're doing. It is going to manifest you within the next few weeks. It won't even take a month or so, or maximum a month. It is going to manifest for you big time, dear friends. You have the inner strength. The angels are saying you have the inner strength. You are very strong. You will be able to multiply this opportunity to your benefit, dear friends. Don't fear this risk. Take this opportunity. They say you have great courage and kindness. You may not realize how strong and powerful you are, but there is no problem you can't solve. The compassion you so freely give to others must also be given to yourself. Stand strong in your convictions if the right answer to tell someone is no. Wow, beautiful, dear friends. You are very strong. You have the inner strength. And if you know, in making this move to another country, in making this move for this marriage commitment to another state, or to study, to whatever this divinely guided idea that you have, which is going to multifold your abundance, if you have to say no to your parents, your partners, to the people who are holding you back to manifest this great opportunity in your life, dear friends, have the courage, have the strength, and tell them, no, I'm going to do this for myself, because, dear friends, it is going to manifest big time for you, and then your friends and family will be very happy for you. We have the Sun card over here, which tells me that your solar plexus chakra is also absolutely healed, dear friends. Beautiful. The sun is shining the light on you. You are in your chakras are healed to manifest abundance for you right now, dear friends. Opportunities of abundance are going to come towards you, and you have to take the risk, dear friends. Your immortal spirit, purpose, and destiny is involved. Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, dear friends. I can't just tell you how much the spirit is telling you to take this leap of faith to, you know, start this new thing, to move to another country, to do whatever this new opportunity comes to you. This is immortal spirit, dear friends, purpose and destiny. This is fated event for you. This is fated, this is destiny. This commitment for business, this commitment for marriage, this commitment which is coming to you from another country, another state, from far off people, is destined for you, dear friends. This is your destiny. Say no to all of those negative mindset people who do not know your destiny. You are fated, dear friends, for success. Beautiful pile number 2, wheel of fortune, 9 of cups, satisfaction, commitments. Just within the few weeks, you are going to come and tell me. And dear friends, I want you to give your comments in the comment box below. I want to understand if this reading relates to you. Is there anything that is coming towards you, or do you sense this kind of energy for yourself? Please let me know, dear friends. So pile number 4, I'm very, very happy for you. You're going to multifold your abundance by taking this leap of faith for this opportunity. I wish you all the best.